Hello everyone and welcome to a new camera angle. Shocking, that's right, you get a whole new chance cam. And today, we're going to be talking about one of the weirdest TikTok accounts I've ever seen. And it's TikTok, so there's a lot of weird things on there. It is by the name of Brunna Brunna or something, I don't know how to read. And it is a wonderful Spanish comedy sketch channel. The reason I say that with such uncertainty is I don't know what this channel is. And I think the best way for you to understand is for me to just play some clips for you. Yeah. I don't know if they take place in like an opposite universe where this is the norm, or if this is some ARG or something, in which case, amazing world building, I think. So, I don't know if this is some, you know, whatever Spanish-speaking country they're in culture, to just, you know, walk around and whenever someone makes me mad, just go. Hey, anyone that speaks Spanish or is from a Spanish-speaking country, these people accurately represent you? I'm assuming that everywhere I go in one of these countries, I'm just going to see people walking around, like, screaming and finger-gunning at each other. And that's how society is there, right? Well, I'm going to take this, and this is 100% how I think of those countries now. Such an experience. I feel like I went through an entire emotional journey when watching that video. What gets me about this video is how they acted so like feel good about themselves after they stuck the money in the child's pants, even though he totally would have noticed. And they're like, dude, he asked for money and you pushed him over with it. You're not a good person. Oh my god, how funny would it be if at the end of the video, it makes him think like he's gonna give him money, but then he just pushes him over again.
Yeah, screw poor people. No, just throw out your money.
Jesus Christ! The jean shorts man just poisoned him! He got away with it scot-free! Scot-free, I tell you! We gotta bring this guy to justice! Poisoned that man! I cannot even begin to comprehend what the hell is going on here. I just don't know. Let's try to break this down. So, she walks in, and he proposes to her. Apparently, this random woman on the street, and she pretends to sleepwalk to avoid him, like, as you would. You don't just propose to someone you don't know. I don't know, maybe this is what they do in Spanish-speaking countries. And then her purse gets stolen. And then she gets the guy, and he's like, oh, sorry. I'm gonna sleepwalk now. You're gonna ignore me proposing to you when we've never met before? Sleepwalk. So you'll notice that these videos are a tad bit misogynist, especially when we get to some of the later ones. Women are just kind of objects that, you know, you just kind of throw around, maybe, that you just kind of possess them. So, yeah, it gets progressively worse, but this is where it starts to, when you start to really kind of notice it.
If you want to hit the road, then let's go then. Let's just go and see the world and just show them what it really means to live like golden. Yeah, we're golden, baby, yeah, we're golden.
So, let's break this down. This woman is getting harassed, so this man comes over and beats him up. And then she immediately falls for him because, you know, that's what you do. And then they do the handshake. He was on his side. And then, bro, that is the only text that I've ever seen in this entire account. It's just bro. So, moral of the story, it is okay to pay people to harass women and then save them to look good. Yeah, I told you it gets a little... Ooh, is this okay? Wish I could raise you, make you happy, but I'm a bad liar, bad liar. The funniest thing about this video to me is after he throws his girlfriend on the ground and the other guy come in like steals her, because, you know, women are just objects you pass around. He looks so confused. He's just standing there like, how could they leave me after I literally just chucked them on the ground? Like a piece of change I didn't like. So, here's my version of that. Wish I could raise you, make you happy, but I'm a bad liar, bad liar.
Oh, yeah, let's just...
Vida!
Oi!
Você tá sabendo que a Maria terminou com o marido dela porque pegou fotos, vídeos e conversa no telefone dele, nesse tal de Google Fotos?
E foi?
Foi!
Oxi.
Deixa eu ver o seu!
So, I don't speak Spanish, but... I don't think if I did speak Spanish, I would understand this. Especially the part where the guy's just hammering the street when the teacher tells you to look busy. And that nightmarish laughter. Who laughs like that? And don't answer, because I don't want to meet them. So this guy's just picking up trash, and they're all laughing at him because that's what you do when someone picks up litter. You go, stupid. He's a good person. And then he walks over, and, you know, apparently is very strong. As he gently goes, and she just goes, like she's in a lot of pain. And he just Grand Theft Auto the car. What's the moral of the story here? Don't laugh at people picking up trash, or they'll steal your car. I think that's the moral of the story. That's what I took away from it, at least. I'm gonna reactivate your exhibition ass. I gotta put the bone in, so better put the... Yet another emotional story from Bruno Bruno, where he befriends a crippled person who sacrifices his life to delay his death because he still has more bullets in his gun. You don't just have a gun with one bullet. I mean, he may have taken the bullet for him, but he has another one. He's still gonna shoot him. But moral of the story, befriend crippled people because they're useless unless they're taking bullets for you. So this is one of the most misogynist TikToks because let's just break down the semblance of a moral here. She's walking on the street, and this guy is like, you know, like catcalling her, harassing her. He's like, yo, call me. And she's like, no. And then these creepy guys on a motorcycle come over, and this guy just walks over and goes, you're mine now. And then they can't do anything now. So the moral of the story is, settle for the less creepy guy, or else more creepy guys will come after you. And if I could, I'd get you the moon and give it to you. And if death was coming for you, I'd give my life on you. Cause you are the reason why I'm still hanging on. So I had to rewatch this TikTok many times to understand the M. Night Shyamalan twist going on, but I think I got it. So at the beginning, you're led to believe, with the masterful writing of Bruno Bruno, that she's a dirty pickpocket that takes this man's hard-earned money. But then, we have a flashback sequence to a blind person who is given money, and then this guy walks over and goes, and then takes it, but she actually took his money that he took from the blind person and gave it back to him. Whoa, this story is packed with characters that you don't expect. Their motivations, it's brilliant. It's a brilliant story with so many twists and turns. I don't even still know if I got it right. There's so much here to interpret. This is cinema. Jesus Christ! She just murdered that woman! All he was doing is waving at her! It wasn't even that bad! Oh my God! She's gonna go to jail! That was not worth it, lady. That was not worth it. By the way, I like it how, when he doesn't see her, like when he turns around, he starts patting himself down like she might be in his pocket. Yeah, that moment when I lose one of my friends, so I go, are they in my pocket? Trent, get out of my pocket. Holy crap, man! I was just waving at him! You didn't have to kill him!
He was interrupting. interrupting our conversation. Do you realize how rude that is?
911, there's been a murder.
Excuse me? Are you talking to the police when we're
talking? No, I'm not.
So, that was an interesting journey to say the least. I want to thank Eli, Trent, and Calvin for generously lending their support in these skits. We did, go watch another Chance Cam video if you want. Go watch another video, because this video is over. You don't know the half of the abuse. Ice, ice on my wrist.